rap, Michael Jack, I'ma let her know. And if she do how she say, then I can't let her go. I can't let her go. I can't let her go. I can't let her go.
Big trays on it. I was going to take it off, but I figured couldn't be bothered. So from the last video that I made, I showed you I've painted everything, but everything was apart. So all I've done is put all the new rubbers in, put it all back together, and yeah, so basically it's all back together now. It's drivable, as you can see, because I drove all the way down here. And what I've done since then, after I put it all back together, I put the exhaust back on, because where it was, if you come down here, the exhaust is right here, right? So in behind the chassis, there's a massive tie rod that goes down. It's a tie rod, but it hooks onto the sway bar. And the exhaust was right up against that, and it was vibrating. So we had to cut 10 mil off the exhaust and then put a sleeve over it so that it'd fit over the top of it. So I put a sleeve over it. All right. On this side, it's basically the same thing, just without an exhaust. So, on this side, as you should notice, the hot wires aren't on this side, because I just smacked them on there because they look cool on the back. What I'm planning to do is get some real thick 15-16 inch rims, Holden rims, put some nice fat tires on them, then put hubcaps on them just to like make it look really cool. And then, what I've spent all week doing is the sides. So these are the sides that are on the tray, which box it in so you can fill it up without anything falling out. And so I've spent all week putting the hinges on, cutting the old hinges off, and because they're all alloy rivets, they were so hard to get off. And eventually I'm going to paint them. I've done the same for these ones. And yeah, so I'll paint them eventually. And if you come up here, all I think I'm going to do, I had a look at it the other day, the tie rods and all of the grease joints and all of that, they're not too bad, they're still pretty good, so I might not replace them. I reckon I'm just going to get new coils to lower it so that it's 2-inch low at the front and back. And yeah, so thank you so much for watching my videos. Make sure to like and subscribe, turn on the post notifications so you don't miss an upload, and tune in next time for whatever video that I'm making next.